It is my honor now to present the next two wonderful alumni awards. The first is what we call our Leading Through Innovation Award. The Leading Through Innovation Award recognizes alumni who have achieved excellence as innovative leaders in their fields. It is my honor to present this award to Niantic Inc. CEO and co-founder and friend, John Hanke. John is receiving this award in recognition for his creation of the cultural phenomenon that have forever altered the way we interact in this world. And there are many of them, in fact. They are phenomena. He is a creative force behind several tools that have become part of all of our daily lives. That includes Google Maps, gaming, computers, were childhood interests of John's. While pursuing his MBA here at Haas, he joined a startup, Archetype Interactive, a video game design company that was founded by Steve Sellers, MBA 96. Together, Hanke and Sellers created one of the first 3D massively multiplayer role-playing online games. Post-graduation, John founded a company, a geospatial data visualization company. It was called Keyhole. That was eventually acquired by Google. Under his watch at Google, VP of product management of their geo division, John oversaw the development of Keyhole into products including Google Earth, Maps, and Street View. More recently, as CEO and co-founder of the gaming company Niantic Labs, John re-envisioned the relationship between technology and human interaction, creating Pokemon Go, a game in which online activity drives in-person interaction. It was quite a cultural phenomenon, as you know, the craze around the world when it launched in summer 2016. We're super lucky to have John's ongoing support of many activities on campus. He's one of our executive fellows at the Haas School. He comes back on campus at least a few times a year. He shares his knowledge and experience with our students. They truly value his real-world business experience, his stories, and so much of what he's achieved. John, your vision, your ability to challenge the status quo has allowed millions, literally, of people to see and experience our world in a different way. Please join me on stage to accept your award.
Wow. Thank you, Dean Lyons. So, I'm deeply honored to be this year's recipient of the Leading Through Innovation Award and to be sharing the evening with Dr. Nunaka and my former classmate, Monica Stevens. And by the way, Monica, what an amazing contribution you are making. And let's hear another round of applause for her. It's readily apparent that Monica is a much more recent graduate of the Haas School than I am. I acknowledge that. I'm going to embrace the 1990s because Berkeley and Haas made a huge impact for me, and I just want to talk a little bit about why that is and talk about some of the people that made that happen. So when I arrived on the Berkeley campus back in 1994, putting it out there, I was reconnecting with a childhood dream. As a kid growing up in a small town in West Texas with a population of 1,000 people, one flashing red light, I became fascinated with computers, the first wave of personal computers. And as I was learning the ins and outs of programming, I spent hours and hours poring over magazines, reading about an inspiring cast of characters who were creating the personal computer industry. Folks like Nolan Bushnell at Atari, Jack Tramiel at Commodore, Trip Hawkins at Electronic Arts, and of course Steve Jobs and Steve Wozniak at Apple. They had one thing in common. They were all from this really strange, faraway place called Northern California. Which could have been another planet, as far as I was concerned. After college, my career diverged a bit, but I never lost that passion, and an acceptance letter from Haas opened a really important door for me. And it was at a really interesting time. At that moment, the old economy was about to give way to the new. In 1993, just 1 year before, Marc Andreessen released a piece of software called Mosaic, the world's first web browser. So just as myself and my classmates were making plans to come to Haas, the World Wide Web was being born. And it was a very interesting 2 years. We all showed up, and all of a sudden, everybody's learning the Unix shell. It's all of a sudden a really interesting, cool thing to do. And in the classroom, Jerry Engel and Mario Rosati's entrepreneurship class really became ground zero for our ideas and ambitions. Jerry's here this evening. And it was probably a little bit of a change of tone for the class, because we weren't there to learn how to be investors or consultants. And I think maybe in the past that had been perhaps more the interest. We all wanted to start and run companies. And over the next few years, I got to watch and learn from many of my classmates who did just that while we were going to school. So Jed Katz, who was going to be here tonight, he couldn't make it. He started a company while we were in school called RentNet and sold it to Cendant for quite a few millions of dollars while we were in school. Steve Markowitz and Noah Doyle, who's here this evening, another one of my classmates, founded a company called MyPoints. And I watched them start that company and eventually take it public. Noah. There were others. Kevin Brown helped start a company that was called Ink2Me, one of the very first search engines. Andre Marquis, who's working with the school, helped start a company called CyberGoal, which Noah and his company bought. So incredible stuff was happening. And over the years, in addition to those classmates, I've gotten to work with and learn from so many other super talented folks, including Mike Quigley, who's here this evening. And he had just come from Disney and was pioneering marketing and video games, and I got to rely on his advice over many, many years, and now I get to work with him. So thank you for being here, Mike. But best of all, I was fortunate enough to meet an exceedingly talented and energetic classmate named Steve Sellers. And he invited me into a company that he and his brother were starting to build, and it was creating one of the first 3D internet games, as Rich mentioned. And that really was a really key moment in my life. And Steve was a big brother to me, he's been a business partner to me, and I'm just so delighted that you could be here this evening, Steve. what would be a wildly improbable turn of events, our product attracted the attention of Trip Hawkins, one of those folks that I'd read about as a kid. He founded EA and 3DO, and he actually ended up acquiring our little company on the day of graduation, so it was a nice way to cap off our MBA. It would be an understatement to say that Haas opened doors. Haas was our laboratory. It was our entree to internships, partners, investors, lifelong friends, and future employees. It was the place we traded tips, compared business plans, debated strategy, competed with each other for attention and success, and hounded our professors for contacts and advice. For us, each class took on an urgency as we struggled to apply theory to our nascent companies. Macroeconomics with Professor Rose, micro with Professor Hermelin, finance with Professors Stanton and Professor Lyons, organizational behavior with Professor Chapman, and of course our strategy course with Professor Ocker. So to Dean Lyons and the current faculty, to my good friend and mentor Jerry Engel, and to all of my classmates and former professors, I thank you for the honor tonight. But much more importantly, I thank you for the experiences that I have been able to have because of you. And of course, I want to thank my wife, Holly, who made the entire journey with me and gave us the three children that give all of this meaning and significance for me. So thank you, Holly. I will never stop believing in the greatness of this country and in our public institutions of higher education. And the University of California is one of the best places in the world to turn dreams into reality. And I'm grateful to whomever happened to read my application so many years ago and decided to give this kid from West Texas a front row seat to the future. So thank you.